In our first video about visualization in codices using switches and buttons, I decided to explain movement properties in another video. As you know, in codices, like what I have done here, we can animate visualization elements so that they move or rotate at runtime. So today in this video, we'll learn how to do this and move and rotate objects in our visualization. I'm going to create a standard project in Codesys. Select here programming language. Add visualization to the project. Let's start with the movement. We can move the objects in a visualization in the direction of the X and Y axis. So for that, we need two integer variables inside the program that indicate how much the position of the object in X and Y axis will be shifted. In other words, we can determine with these two variables how much the object to the left and right or top and bottom moves. Go to the visualization and insert an object from the toolbox. I'm going to insert the rectangle. Click on the object. Now, if you look at the properties, you find here absolute movement. Open it. Under movement, we can assign variable for the object's movement in the X and Y directions. Select the variables that we have declared. I'm going to set the initial X and Y both 100 to show you the change better. Save the project. We don't need to use a real PLC, so I use the simulation. Login. Click yes to create the application. Let's change the value of X and Y and see what happens. Let me, for example, set them 40. Write the values. As you see, the position of the object is changed in visualization and the new X and Y position are now 140. In fact, 14 pixel is added to the X and Y position of the element and it has been moved 40 pixels to the right and 40 pixels to the downside. Let's try with another value. We can even change the position from the visualization. To do that, insert two sliders from common controls. One of them we use to change the X position and another one for Y. For the variable of the slider, select our two integer variables for position. Here we can define the minimum and maximum value of the position. Login again. As I said, now I can move the object inside the visualization. If you look at the properties, we can even rotate the object. With this property, we can rotate the object around the center. But what's the meaning of around center? If you click on the rectangle, you see a little circle with a plus sign. This little circle is the reference position or the center of the object. Any object that we insert in our visualization has a reference position by default in the middle of it. When I change the value of the rotation variable, the rectangle will rotate around this reference point. Declare another integer variable. Select it as the variable of rotation. I'm going to copy this slider for rotation. Since the rotation is in degrees, I set the value between 0 and 360. I'm going to insert a little circle to show you the center in the visualization. Let's see the change. As you see now, the rotate variable is 90 and our object is rotated 90 degrees around this point. And now 180 degrees, and with 360 again back to the first place. The next property is scaling. With scaling, we can stretch the object and make it bigger or smaller. The value 1 makes the object 1000 times smaller, and the value 1000 returns the element to its original size. We need another variable and slider for scaling. Scale end, I'm going to set 2000. Login. When I change the scaling, the size of the object regarding the center point changes. With 1, it's 1000 times smaller, and with 1000, it gets again the original size. With more than 1000, we can make it bigger. Alright, next is interior rotation. With this property, the element itself can rotate around the center point. Let's see what's the difference with rotation. I'm going to declare another variable. Copy this rectangle. And we need a slider to change the value. Select the variable for interior rotation. Login. As you see, when I change the value, the object not only rotates around its center, but also rotates itself. But with rotation, it just rotates around the center point. If we set the center point in the middle of the element, then it will rotate just around itself. Now the object rotates just around itself and, in fact, around the middle point of the object. The next option here allows for the individual fine-tuning of moving the element, for example, for the visualization of a smoother rotation. Instead of integer values with offset 1, we can use real values and change the position and angle with smaller values. Okay, what we learned so far was all about the absolute movement of an element in visualization. Under the absolute movement, we have also another property called relative movement. Relative movement can be used to change the x and y position of a single edge of an element. With this property, we can move the top left and bottom right edge of an element. In fact, it changes the size and form of the element. Let's declare four variables of integer: top left x position, top left y, bottom right x, and bottom right y. Copy these four sliders. Change the name and variable. Login again. When I change the top left, as you see, the left side of the element moves to the right or left side. And with changing the top left variable, the upper side is changing. I change the x and y positions bottom right to see the difference. As you see different sides of an element, we can change in this way. Okay, we are finished now with another video tutorial of Codesys. In this video, we'll learn how to move and rotate an object in a visualization of Codesys. I hope that was helpful to you. If you have any questions, write them in comments. Bye, friends.